Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Madhura and I have with me Jyoti. We are not calling ourselves Maddie and Joe. We are sticking with our names. And
by popular
Jyoti,
demand.
By popular demand. Again, let the record show we both love our names. It's just sometimes we get called Maddie and Joe and it's fine. And now that we've put that out there, what are we reacting to today?
We are reacting to something that really caught my eye because we recently reacted to Krishna. You know, for some of the people who left comments saying he's not a new artist, we know. We just said he's a new artist for us. Disclaimer. We put it in our reaction. So yes, we were introduced to Krishna through our last reaction, which was the free verse feast, langar. And that was apparently a diss track to Emiway, who you and I have not heard before, at least I haven't. But anyway, so like people commented that since you are not a fan of diss tracks, here's a song you should react to called Vyanjan by Krishna. Okay. And it's apparently Hindi alphabetic.
Okay, nice. I'm excited.
Really piqued my curiosity and I was like, must check
this
out.
Yes, must.
Because we were amazed by his skill.
Yes, he can really spit words and like he can effortlessly switch between English and Hindi, and the pace at which he raps, I think, like, I'd doff my hat to him.
Yeah.
So Hindi alphabetical rap, I'm very, very excited to see how he's done it, because I think I just want to see the level of creativity there. So I'm excited about this track.
Yeah, let's just get into it straight away.
Let's get into it. Okay.
Okay. One,
ready?
Two, Three,
नमस्ते प्यारे छात्रों, आज हमारे साथ हैं दिल्ली के मशहूर गायक कृष्णा और हम आपको सिखाने जा रहे हैं हिंदी व्यंजन गाना। इस गीत में हम बोलेंगे व्यंजन अक्षर और कृष्णा रैप में गाएंगे उस व्यंजन अक्षर से शुरू होने वाले शब्द। तो फिर क्यों ना शुरू करें?
तो काले करतूत करते कमीने कमाने को काले धन के कारण कंगाल किया कितने किसानों को कत्लेआम के काबिल कौन कृष्णा का कलम कातिल कितने कागजों को काटे कौन खेल खेले कल नायक खिलाड़ी खास खोजे खाद में खजाना खतरनाक ख्यालात खोखली खातेदारी घूम कराबा खूब खतरे खूबसूरत खामोशी या खलबली की खबरें गलतियां गंभीर गमगीन गाना गाएंगे गली गली गरीबी गद्दार गति गवाएंगे गुस्सा गाली गलोच गुनेगारों को गिराएंगे गांव में गतिरोध गन की गोलियां गिनाएंगे घड़ी घड़ी गुस्से घुसपैठी गमन घटाए घटी घमासान घटना घर पे घर वाले घबराए घड़िया घूसखोरी कपलों पे घुड़सवार घर के गणेश गहराई में घड़ियाल चोर चाहे चंदा चोरी चुपके चले चाल चौकन्ने चौकीदार ने चिपकाए चाटे चार क्या चंदू के चाचा ने चंदू को चांदी के चम्मच से चटनी चटाके चोरा चोरी छक्के छुड़ाते छोटी छोटी छटपटाट सुन के छत पे छुप जाते छोटे छात्र करे छेड़खानी तो छट से बड़ी छड़ी छोकरा छुरी छीने छुप के देखे चोर की छवि जनाब लाजवाब जब से लिया है जन्म जय जवान जिनके जीवन दान से जीते जम जानवर जिनकी जाति जंगली जाली जिनकी जान झेला जो झमेला झूठा झुकी जिसकी जान टल्ली टेले टोली टकराते टूटी टांग टीआई टांगे टेढ़ी टोपी टकला था टुकड़ा ठुल्ले ठेठ ठगी ठेकेदार को ठहराता डाकू डाले डाका डेली डांट के डराता ड्रामा डोल ड्रामा डर को घर के ढगमगाता ढक्कन ढीला ढंग से ढके ना तो बिन ढकेले ढल जाता तकलीफे तुझे तड़पाती तमन्ना तेरी तोड़ी तकलीर के ताले तोड़ो तब ये तगड़ी तेरी तोबी तभी तो तपके तलवे तभी से ही तनाई तानाशाही में मचाई तमंचे से तबाही थोड़ा थोड़ा तू तुला थक के थैला थमाता थाने में थप्पड़ पड़े तो थोड़ा थड़थड़ाता देवता दरबान दुनिया के खोले दरवाजे दिल्ली वाले दबंग दगाबाजों को दफनाते धरना धर्मशाला में धुएंदार धमाका तांगली दुनिया धंधे में धड़ाधड़ धूम धड़ाका निराश नागरिक नालायक नेता से नाराज ना इंसाफी का नाश जवाब निशानेबाज पीने पे पाबंदी पटना में पकड़े तो पंगा पाजी पहने पगड़ी पंजाब में पड़े पंजा पाकिस्तान के पड़ोसी परेशान तो भी पिस्तौल पकड़े पठान पर इनाम पार पहुंची फसा फकीर फैला के फसाद फिर भी फरार फिलहाल फौजियों ने करे फटे हाल बंगाल में बवाल बचे बाल बाल बुरे हाल बार में मिसाल बाढ़ बरकरार बार भरे भ्रष्टाचार के भागीदार भगोड़ों की भरमार बारी भर गंभीर चाल मन में मजबूती मजबूरी में मजदूरी मेरा मंत्री मन से मूडी मगर मंत्री बन के मंत्री पद में माला माल यारा याद यॉट मेरा यातायात ये शुरू रातों रात गजाता रास रणभूमि से रवाना, राजपूताना राजा भागा, राजस्थान के रेगिस्तान में रेत इंसान हो जाता रहा। लूट कर लेकर लकड़ी लाया, लाजी लकड़ा लड़की लाजवाब, लाखों लड़की लगातार भर्ती वाले वीर, वो वतन की वफादारी, वैसे वर्तमान में भरभेड़ विनाशकारी, विलंब करे विपक्षी वो वरिष्ठ वकील, शैतान शाना शिकारी, शक्ल से शरीर शटकुन षड्यंत्र, सपने संजीव, संगठन के साथ इसी के सुरीला संगीत, हर हफ्ते होते हत्याकांड, हजारों हारे हौसले, हड़ताल हमारा हक हमारा हमरा ही भाव है। क्षत्रिय त्रो त्रिशूल क्यों ज्ञानी,
और समाप्त हुई हमारी कहानी।
I like the start and end. Very Amin Sayani feel.
Yes.
Chhatro.
Exactly. I was just going to say this sounds like Vivith Bharati when it started, and even the end, Samapt Hui, I'm like, nice. So I didn't think that each line was supposed to be an alliteration. I could not have predicted that. I thought that he'll get a letter or he'll go through the letters of the alphabet and each line. But I didn't think every word of every
I thought it'd be like Antakshari. He'll start with
exactly.
That.
Yeah. Exactly.
But
so that mind is blown. Very impressed. Blown.
Very much blown. You know, you may not agree with every one of his things that
lines.
He's saying.
That
every
is
one
true.
Of his lines,
that is true.
Which happened at certain points for me.
Yes, but, it happened for me as well. But I think I don't want to dissect the lines. With this song, I just want to appreciate the creativity that's
exactly.
gone into one thinking of a track like this, right?
Yeah.
Because eventually that's how the wrap-offs would be, that you either get a word or a beat and you just have to come up with something, right?
Yeah.
So for him to come up with a concept like this and to actually pull it off, I've done the Vyanjan when I was in sixth grade or something, and there are so many words you know but you don't really use, and as each alphabet was being told, like cha or sha or something, and I was like, kahan se isko words milenge? And the fact that he did it, and he also cleverly put like Chandu ke chacha or some of these tongue twisters, each line felt like a tongue twister for me. So I will focus on the creativity. I don't want to dissect the lines and what he said in the lines, because some of them I didn't agree with. Same.
Which is fine. Every artist has his opinion, and that's totally
correct.
Cool. I'm just, so like you said, the idea and the creativity to do a track like this, mm-hmm. but also special mention for the vocabulary mm-hmm. in Hindi, because, you know, even for Hindi speakers, these are words that we've heard but we've never used in our life.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Or in normal lingo and all of that. And like, for me, there were many, but Sir still stands out. And I just Googled the lyrics. So, for like, he's written for Var, he's written, Vardi wale veer wo vatan ki wafadari, vaise vartaman mein varn bhed vinashkari, vilamb kare vipakshi wo varisht vakil. And then, like, who says varisht, you know? Who uses Vartaman mein varn bhed, like, you know, and that for me, Sir really stood out. Sapne Sanjeev, Sangathan ke saathi, seekhe Surila Sangeet. Like, who says Sangathan? I mean, okay, these are words that you will hear, politicians and all use.
Yeah, I was going to say these are words you'll probably hear politicians use in their speeches.
But
very
I will never expect a
it.
Rapper to get into this kind of vocab and just send it. Macha. He has sent it at all.
So no? Yeah, very, very, very impressed with this. This one, I think just the idea and also the execution. You need a certain, so, you know, if anyone has watched the channel, both of us really like it when there is a certain level of intelligence and creativity that comes out when people put together their music, rappers, you know, and I think this one
process
picks up all the
MP, yeah, bahut
exactly
ehmiyat
rakhta hai,
yeah,
exactly. So I think that way it picked up. I'm impressed with myself. I'm inspired by him. Of course, ehmiyat is not Hindi.
But
ye bahut mahatvapurna hota hai.
Yes, because the thing is, and I'm seeing he's not, I mean, Okay, it's very easy to switch from Urdu to Hindi, and also there's confusion that happens on that front also by many people. You know, ye Hindi ka shabd hai ya Urdu ka
hai.
Yes, loves. See, full. It's dripping now.
I think he ticks off boxes for me. I
want to go through the lyrics properly later, because there is a lot of Urdu use as well, like janab, lajawab, jab se jiye hai janab. You know, so there'll always be a mix. It happens without.
I don't think I also think that. I mean, one can't be that Puritan about it. And to be fair, there is nowhere when he says that he'll only use Hindi words, right? So when he was rapping, I think I was just going with how he was stringing words together and the alphabets and the alliterations and how he was keeping them going without it turning into some inane sophomoric line, right? There was still a certain level of intelligence that was coming out in each one of the lines. So I think, I did notice the Urdu words, because they, you know, you kind of catch them. But I was like, do I want to get head up about it? No problem.
No, of course not. But I'm just, in the last song, he said, that's how you represent India. So from the comments, I came to know that he did that diss because MAA was saying that he's the only one representing Indian hip hop and stuff like that. So even apparently that went up Brother V's nose, and he also kind of hit back at him in a line or so in one of his songs. Mm-hmm. But this one went all out and did his diss, and he's like, that's how you represent India. And then this comes out and people are like, yeah, he's representing India. My only thing is, why are these videos and songs not getting views in the millions, you know? Because this is serious, serious talent. And then you have the Honey Sings. I will take names. You will have the Honey Sings and the Badshah. Badshah, toh, let's not even go to, because he's admitted he bought views and likes on his recent release. But come on, people, you gotta support this kind of music. Spread the word.
I think we need to also find out about them. Hip hop R&B, I think, has got it's always been underground. I think things, I mean, outings like the documentary about the rap scene in Bombay or India, or even Gully Boy, in a way have put that on the map for the right kind of rappers. I wouldn't call Badshah, like, I don't know, he's very... Honey Singh, I think, had potential. He had potential when he started out, but I think at some point... Honey Singh started out,
International Villager will always be an awesome album.
Exactly.
But then he lost the plot.
So in his case, I think it's unfortunate. It's kind of wasted potential. But Badshah, I don't know. Like, Raftaar should be getting a lot more, talk, because again, I think Raftaar is also talented. Because you're making that face. I was like, you're making that face for Raftaar. No, for Badshah.
So this label is Raftaar's. Kalamkar is something that Raftaar started to promote artists.
Rappers.
But again, artists. Like, I want to talk about the phrase underground, because nobody really as an artist wants to stay underground. The reason it's called underground is because it hasn't been discovered, or people haven't really been exposed to those artists or that music. And that happens because you and I know as radio professionals that we don't... Well, that's not the kind of music that will get you more listenership or whatever. So in a programming format, you'll not be including music like this, which kind of happens a lot, right, around India and other radio networks and all of that. So that's the reason these people stay underground. But now with YouTube and all the freely available platforms for you to put out your content and your creativity, you don't need to be referred to as an underground artist anymore, is what I feel, which is why I was just saying that people, come on, go and give more views to artists like this.
And so let that is
not be underground anymore.
the thing is that certain things, so I see underground as let's call them niche and let's call them popular, right? There are, every market is very segmented, every place has its own preference, right? So I mean, it's okay if there is a, let's say, majority of India consumes film-based music, right? So for us, most music has come as part of the soundtrack of film. So we consume that. So unless and until you go out of your way to discover other forms of music, they will always stay niche. Yes, there is a different machinery that is at play here, which is whether they kind of, the record labels, the kind of representation and the kind of platforms that they get. I definitely do think that social media has kind of democratized things to a certain extent, but I think it still depends on preferences, right? Just like how we talk about rap, then we can also talk about classical music, like traditional forms of music that are, like, you have tribal music where, you know, they will always remain in these pockets because either people are unaware of them or they don't have platforms like more popular ones. And the popular ones are, you know, dictated by the economies of profit and bottom lines and things like that. So
now I think the music streaming apps have a bigger important role to play because people are creating their own playlists on these apps and they want these kind of tracks to also be available, because I've seen in comment sections on YouTube also, oh, when is your song coming out on Spotify, or when is your song coming out on whatever platform, and the artist will be like soon. So hum apni personal playlist mein usko add kar sakte hain, and then that gets more plays, right, on that app.
It does. So I now also think that
apps have to make sure they have this in their catalogs, all kinds of music.
They will, again, there again it goes into the performance and the licensing and all of it, right? There's a whole different aspect of having somebody's music. That's a different thing altogether. But again, I will also not just place the, it's very easy to say the apps have to do their work. I think it's also completely, listeners also have to have that inherent curiosity, right? You cannot find music if you don't want to find music. If you're very happy with the same 20 songs you listen to, then
really
the
sad.
Apps can do everything that happens, and you can't blame the apps. I mean, you can't place the responsibility solely on them. I think everybody also, I mean, if possible, if they have the appetite, they should be curious to kind of expand their horizons of music and say, you know, let me check it out. You know, so what? You know, it's very unlike what I would normally listen, but hey, let me surprise myself. So I think people who consume music also have to do that to give these artists the platforms, because their loyal fans will always do it, right? But for them to grow, then others need to find out about them.
So in a nutshell, audiences shouldn't just be passive listeners. They need to get more proactive and try and expand their own musical horizons. Sum it up. Just don't keep listening to what people are throwing at you. Go look for stuff yourself.
Yes, go down a rabbit hole. Just click on things, you know. If a artist sounds interesting, go and explore them. It doesn't have to be something that you see on a music channel, or it doesn't have to be something that's thrown at you for you to consume. You can also pick and choose what you consume. And I think with so much choice, everybody should exercise that.
Yeah. And on that very positive note.
Yes.
I will not use the other word. We will end this here.
And we will see you in the next one. Before we go on and on about this.
So, yeah, we are very passionate about this music business.
Yes. So please like, comment and subscribe. And also let us know where you discover new music. How do you discover new music? What's the new artist that you recently discovered who's very unlike what you would normally listen to? Let us know. We also love discovering new music. So yeah, you know what to do. Like, comment and subscribe. And we'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.